everybody. So today we're going to be drawing a chimney swift. So chimney swifts are really cool little birds that nest and roost in chimneys. They eat insects. They can eat up to 1,000 insects a day, which is pretty crazy. So to start with, we're going to draw the head. Whenever you're drawing, I like to break it down into really simple shapes so that you're not super overwhelmed. And it just makes it easier to draw. So we're going to start with the head. And then we'll use that to proportion the rest of our body. So I've kind of drawn on this one already, like on my reference photo, if you can see that. You can do that as well if you'd like. You don't have to. Just help me to gather my thoughts. All right, so there's our head circle. And next I'm just gonna draw line right here just to help to line the rest of the body up, and then do a line on the other side of the head as well. Again, we're just lining stuff up, and we're gonna just do a line through the middle as well. Okay, now we've got this body circle. So the body circle, let's measure the head and see how big it is in proportion to the head. So that's 1, 2 and about a half. So we're gonna go with that. So now that I've figured out what the ratio is, I'm gonna use this head and go 1, 2 and about a half. So that's about there. So I'm gonna mark it off with just a little tick mark. Now let's see how far out the body circle goes. So it comes to this line on that side. But on this side, it goes way out past. So let's see. That I'd say is about 3/4 of that. So if like we cut the head in half there, that's gonna be about how far. So we're going out from this far edge line right here. And make a tick. So that's the dimensions for our circle, like the body circle. All right, so there's our body oval. And let's just get the posture line in here. So the posture line's good to have because it just indicates what direction the bird's turned in. And if that's all that you, if like all you get down is like the head and the body circle and you're like drawing a bird outside, you're still gonna know approximately what the bird's doing. Cause like some birds, they sit in a way that's like really characteristic of their species. Like if you look at a flycatcher, they always sit at this like perfect angle. I couldn't explain why to you at the moment, but that's just really characteristic for that species. And same with like wrens have characteristic postures, so it's just good to have that posture line in it. Since this bird's turn, we're gonna have to follow that. I'd say it goes something like that though. So next we're gonna use proportions to add in different body parts. So I'm gonna start just by making a line across here. Just so that we've got that as a reference line. Next, we're going to add in this circle that I've got around the tail. Just kind of mark that out. So let's see how high up I've got this going. So that's about half a head. So put it half a head and go up half a head. It's about right there. Okay, and let's see how far down the circle goes. So it's about 1 3/4. Okay, and let's see how far in it goes as well. Half a head. Perfect. So that's actually exactly that measurement out. That's a half a head. So perfect, there's our tail circle. Okay, and let's now get where the, basically the top of the shoulder goes. Where does that go? It's about a head down, so we'll do that. So that's one head. And this wing in the back. About a body. So body starting from bottom of the body circle to top of the head. That's like the whole body. Okay. And wing. See how that is in reference to the body. About the same, it just goes up a little bit into just a tiny bit past, so we'll just use that again. So about here and here. So next we're gonna carve in angles and some key features. So because, like, we all know that birds aren't a bunch of balls stuck together. Like, it's got some shape to it, so. Okay, so there's some angles for the head. You can see how this is kind of angled around the head circle. And let's make this wing a bit more. Actually, let's start this wing. How far? That. So if we extend this line, you'll see that the wing just about comes to touch it, and it comes out from here. So it's gonna go kind of like that. Okay. I'm gonna have to do a bit of erasing a little bit, but for now, don't need to worry about that. See how this kind of does like a bit of a dip? Don't know if you can hear it, but there's a Phoebe singing in the background. Spring. Very excited about that. Okay, and that's just kind of a jumble, so let's just get rid of some of those lines in there. There, that looks way better. Okay. And let's just add the spikes on the end of the tail. Remember how I said that these were used by the Chimney Swift to help it grip? Just one of many really cool adaptations that Chimney Swifts have for their particular lifestyle in a chimney. They're perfectly built for clinging. Chimney Swifts also have super long wings, and this is perfect for spending almost their entire day in the air. Like, literally, they stop flying to sleep and sleep or work on their nest or that sort of thing. You also notice this right here. I'm gonna add that in. But they mate in flight, they eat insects, bathe, collect nest materials, they just do everything. It's pretty cool. So next we're going to indicate some feather groups. Rather than drawing every individual feather, I like to draw feathers in groups so it just suggests where the feathers are going to be. It's a lot less overwhelming, and it makes sure that you don't make the bird look scaly. So this is just how I like to start. So we're going to start with drawing this big group right here. It's actually called the mantle. It does not matter what's called for your purposes, but we'll start with that. So let's see how far down it goes. Perfect, one head width. And this is why I drew those lines at the beginning, just so I have something to reference off of. You always need that reference point, and then see how it just comes a little bit past there? So we're gonna come just a little bit past there. Sorry, this is the line I was referring to. I'm sure there wasn't overly obvious what I was talking about. Okay, and now we're going to draw the, this is called the culverts right here. Again, doesn't overly matter, but it's useful because like you can see how like, there's just that kind of line. And then we're going to draw the second group. So this would be primary culverts and then the median culverts. Alright, now let's get some of the feather groups on the face. So first we're just going to get that white chin. We pretty well got already because of just how the circles worked when we were marking it up. See how it just kind of lines up nicely? It's convenient, isn't it? It's totally planned. Because birds kind of follow. Birds follow like a certain pattern of what they're doing. Like every bird that you draw, the more birds that you draw, the more you'll notice patterns. That kind of. Okay, where's the eye fall? Not quite half. I'd say it's just a little bit over half. Comes up halfway in between this line and this line. I'll come back and change these face markers, but just get something down. And we'll just throw the eye in there. So now we're going to start adding in basic details and removing unneeded lines. So let's just start by erasing. See how we've got these feather groups that we've indicated. Now we're going to start adding in a little bit of feathers. So And that's our Chimney Swift. You could continue going into detail and just keep adding and adding and adding, but sometimes you just need to decide it's done. And I think this is good enough to be happy with.